2025 was an incredible year to be a fan of dinosaurs and paleontology. Jurassic World Rebirth brought new life into the franchise, and while many of the new dinosaur designs were absolute bangers, a few certainly stirred up debate amongst fans. Alongside the film, we also got Jurassic World Evolution 3, featuring brand new species and the long-awaited addition of baby dinosaurs. Prehistoric Kingdom definitely kept that excitement going, letting our imaginations run wild with its own lineup of baby animals that gradually grow into adults, plus the surprise inclusion of the granddaddy of tetrapods himself, Tiktaalik. And if that wasn't enough, prehistoric planet Ice Age took us deep into the Pleistocene, introducing us to everything from mighty Colombian mammoths to giant armadillos. Altogether, paleo media really felt like it entered a new golden age this year. And fittingly, 2025 was just as remarkable for the field of paleontology itself. We saw the discovery of novel flipper structures in Temnodontosaurus, a new pterosaur species found from fossilized spinosaur vomit, the incredibly awesome Mirasaura, and of course, a whole wave of newly identified dinosaurs and dinosaur discoveries. In this video, I'm joined by several creators and paleo enthusiasts, and we'll be covering 12 of some of the most exciting new dinosaur discoveries of the year. Take it away, Dino Guy.
We're kicking things off in January with the discovery of Tamariraptor markgrafi. Surprisingly, the story of its discovery began over 110 years ago. The fossils were first collected in 1914 by Ernst Stromer's team. But sadly, the specimen was destroyed during World War II, in the same bombing raid that destroyed the original fossils of Spinosaurus. For decades, it was lumped in with Carcharodontosaurus, until 2025, when scientists re-examined Stromer's notes, photographs, and surviving casts, and realized it was a whole new species. It lived during the Late Cretaceous of Egypt around 95 million years ago. Its fossils were from the same Bahariya formation that gave us famous giants like Paralotitan and, of course, Spinosaurus. What makes Tamariraptor special is that it's the only African Carcharodontosaurid found with a partial skeleton beyond just teeth and skull bits, which gives us rare insight into its body structure. Tamariraptor reached around 8 to 9 meters in length. It would have been slightly smaller than Carcharodontosaurus, but still a large and impressive predator in its own right. Like its relatives, it had a lightweight and powerful skull filled with sharp, serrated teeth. These teeth would have been more suited for slicing flesh off of prey. The neighboring theropod, Spinosaurus, had conical teeth, which were better suited for snatching up fish. So the two megatheropods were able to coexist here for the most part, thanks to niche partitioning. But unlike other Carcharodontosaurids, it sported a distinctive horn-like bump on its snout. This horn may have likely been used as a display feature. While the original bones are forever lost, Tamariraptor has finally stepped out of the shadows as one of Egypt's great and unique predators. A perfect way to start the year of dinosaur discoveries. For February, this next dinosaur comes from the Late Cretaceous of Coahuila, Mexico, in the Cerro del Pueblo formation. Say hello to Mexidrachen longimanus, a unique ornithomimid part of the group often called ostrich dinosaurs. Mexidrachen stands out from its relatives because of the extremely long hands. Paleontologists think that these elongated arms may have helped it gather vegetation more efficiently. It's also possible that these animals used these bizarre hands to help capture fish too. Unlike the speedy, ostrich-like runners that most people imagine when they think of ornithomimids, Mexidrachen probably wasn't built for speed. Its leg proportions suggest that it was slower, with a more slender foot that may have not handled muddy terrain very well.
Up next in March, we have one of the coolest therizinosaurs ever discovered. Deuonychus sungbartari hails from the Late Cretaceous of Mongolia. Its name means two claws, and for good reason. The fossil, discovered in 2012, was formally described in 2025, comes from the Bayan-Shiri Formation, an area already famous for therizinosaurs, like the gigantic Segnosaurus. There is even another new species found this year, which we'll get to in a bit. The holotype of Deuonychus was an immature animal, weighing around 260 kilograms, and likely reached around 3 meters in length. What makes this species truly remarkable is its hand anatomy. The third finger is reduced into a splint-like bone, while the remaining claws are large, strongly curved, and uniquely preserved. One specimen even includes the first complete keratinous claw sheath ever found in a non-Paravian theropod. This sheath increased the claw's size by more than 40%, giving Deinonychus an impressively hooked, powerful grip. Its elbow and first finger also had an unusual, restricted motion. Combined with those enlarged claws, Deinonychus likely used its arms like plant-grabbing hooks, pulling vegetation towards its mouth. In a formation full of strange, scythe-armed dinosaurs, Deinonychus still manages to stand out, showing us a new and unexpected twist in how these gentle, pot-bellied theropods used their iconic claws.
Now let's take a much-needed break for theropods and introduce a new sauropod, Cienci Argentina Sanchezi, a newly named Rebecasaurid from Argentina's Huincul Formation. Described in April of 2025, it's known from three partial skeletons of different sizes, making it the fourth combined Rebecasaurid from the famous rock unit. The holotype includes an impressive collection of bones, neck, back, and tail vertebrae, ribs, parts of the pelvis, and even sets of leg bones, giving us a surprisingly complete look at this long-necked plant eater. Though still fragmentary, the discovery helps fill in the diversity of South America's mid-Cretaceous sauropods, and highlights just how rich the Huincul Formation continues to be. And the sauropod train continues to chug along into May. Our next dinosaur is Jingchuanglong Niedu, a Eurosauropod from the Xinghe Formation in China. It lived during the Middle Jurassic period, roughly 168 to 165 million years ago. What makes Jingchuanglong very special is that it's known from a partial but very informative skeleton. The holotype was discovered in 2017, and it continues something we almost never get for early sauropods, a nearly complete skull. The skull of Jingchuanglong is about 31 centimeters long, and resembles those of other famous Chinese sauropods like Momenchisaurus youngi. Since only the very front and very back of the skeleton are preserved, the full body length is estimated at around 10 meters, and evidence suggests that this individual was a juvenile. Jingchuanglong gives a very valuable new window into the early evolution of long-necked dinosaurs in Asia, and it's always a treat when a sauropod skull survives well enough for scientists to study it in detail.
We now return back to the Bayan-Sherry Formation, only this time, instead of another therizinosaur, we have a new tyrannosaur species, Kankulu mongoliensis. Its bones were first found in the 1970s and originally misidentified as the Chinese predator Electrosaurus. It then wasn't until 2025 that researchers finally recognized them as a completely new genus. Kankulu was a medium-sized tyrannosauroid, standing about 2 meters at the hips, stretching at least twice that in length and weighing around 750 kilograms. Their skull wasn't preserved in full, but the available bones suggest a shallow, elongated profile, while their legs were long and slender, built more for speed than brute force. What makes Kankulu especially important is that its skeleton blends traits from both early and advanced tyrannosauroids, filling in a key evolutionary gap. In the Bayan-Sherry Formation, Kankulu's size and agility would have helped to hunt the region's therizinosaurs like Deinonychus and Segnosaurus.
Up next, we have an exciting new dromaeosaur, Shri Rapax. Shri is a genus of small dromaeosaurids from the Jodokta Formation of Late Cretaceous Mongolia, with Shri Rapax described in July of 2025 from a beautifully preserved, nearly complete skeleton. Unfortunately, the skull has since been lost, but the detailed documentation of the entire skeleton gives us a very clear picture of what this little predator was like. Shri Rapax lived in the same ecosystem as Velociraptor, and the two were very similar in many ways, both being lightly built, fast-moving hunters. However, Shri also had several key differences. Its snout was shorter and sturdier, its tooth row extended further back, and its skull bones interlocked more tightly, all features suggesting that it had a stronger bite than Velociraptor. Even its hands were specialized, sporting an unusually large inner claw on the first finger. These traits point to niche partitioning. Velociraptor and Shri weren't competing for exactly the same prey, but occupying slightly different hunting roles. In this challenging desert landscape, Shri Rapax carved out its own place as a compact but powerful little predator.
So far, we've had a ton of theropods and a couple of sauropods, but no Ornithischian dinosaurs on this list. Thankfully, August delivers with the Istorhynchus macarthura. Istorhynchus is a newly described iguanodontin from the early Cretaceous Wessex formation of the Isle of Wight, England. Known from a partial skeleton, this species stood out from other iguanodontins of the region thanks to its dramatically elongated neural spines. These spines likely formed a sail-like structure along its back and may have acted as a display structure. The fossil includes vertebrae from the neck, back, sacrum, and tail, as well as parts of the pelvis, giving researchers a surprisingly good look at this unusual ornithopod. Next, we have one of the most exciting discoveries from Mongolia, Zavacephalae rhinopoche, the earliest and most complete pachycephalosaur ever found. Discovered in the Kurunduk Formation, Zavacephalae gives us our best look at how these dome-headed dinosaurs began. The nearly complete skeleton shows a fully developed dome, surprisingly advanced for such an early member of the group. And the rest of the skeleton is just as remarkable. At 54% complete, it is the most complete pachycephalosaur known, preserving features we've never seen before, such as a full hand, a massive gastrolis, and an entire tail stiffened with ossified tendons. It even includes parts of the pelvis and hind limbs. Despite this impressive dome, this individual was still growing when it died, but it most likely would not have gotten much larger. It was about 1 meter long and under 6 kilograms when it was died, and it was a fast, yet agile animal. As the oldest definitive pachycephalosaur, Zavacephalae sits right at the root of the group's family tree, showing that the iconic domed skull evolved early and more completely than anyone expected.
Now, if there is one thing that rings true this year in paleontology, it is that the fossil record can dramatically subvert our expectations and even challenge long-held beliefs. Perhaps one of the best examples of this was that the long-controversial Nanotyrannus truly was its own genus and not a juvenile T-Rex. After decades of ongoing debate, paleontologists James Napoli and Lindsay Zeno helped prove to the world that Nanotyrannus lancensis was its own species. Even more surprisingly, their findings showed that Jane, the previously dubbed Teen Rex, was significantly different from the dueling dinosaur specimen and the original Cleveland skull. This led paleontologists to conclude that Jane represented a new species, which they declared as Nanotyrannus letheus. Nanotyrannus letheus is believed to have an estimated mass of 833.93 kilograms or 1,838.5 pounds, and it reached lengths of 6 to 7 meters and stood 1.9 meters tall. It's worth mentioning that these animals likely got much larger, as Jane had died young. The discovery of Nanotyrannus as a separate genus with two species has completely changed our perception of Tyrannosaurus rex ontogeny and the diversity of late Cretaceous ecosystems.
Hey kids, did you want another new Mementosaurus species? November, Mementosaurus sanjiangensis was published, making it the 8th species in the genus. This animal is known from a partial skeleton from the Shashimao Formation, located in Chongqing, China. Phylogenetically, Mementosaurus sanjiangensis appears to be a more derived member of the Mementosaurids, closely related to other Mementosaurus species. However, the fossils also show a unique mix of features that independently evolved to resemble those of neosauropods. This suggests that Mementosaurids may have responded by evolving strategies that allowed them to maintain their dominance in East Asia.
And last, but certainly not least, we have an exciting avian dinosaur discovery to finish off the year. Chromiornis funkii is a newly described member of the Longipterygids, a unique family of Enantiornithine birds known for their extremely long beaks and toothed snouts. Based on its size and body proportions, Chromiornis would have been one of the smallest members of this family of funky-faced birds. Chromiornis is exceptionally well-preserved, with soft tissue impressions around the eyes, patches of feathers, and faint limb outlines that reveal muscle placement, limb movements, and even the aerodynamic limits of early birds. But even more surprising than its preservation was the discovery of over 800 tiny stones packed tightly inside its neck. CT scans and chemical analyses confirmed the stones were swallowed during life. Paleontologist Dr. Jianmai O'Connor suggests that this may have been a result of illness-driven behavior or a failed attempt to regurgitate. In a single fossil, Chromiornis doesn't just show us what early birds looked like. it captures a moment of tragic behavior, preserving one of the most funkiest causes of death ever recorded in the fossil record.
But wait, there is one more surprise dinosaur in store. Meet Manipulonyx reshetavi, the newest dinosaur from the Mongolian Nemet Formation. Manipulonyx was an alvarosaurid, closely related to species like Mononychus. In addition to Manipulonyx's fingers being noticeably reduced with a giant claw, its hands also had dermal ossifications on the palm and sides. These features likely helped the animal handle round, hard-to-grip objects like eggs. Scientists believe that eggs may have made a large part of its diet, offering unique insight into the feeding behavior of these unusual dinosaurs. Talk about an amazing discovery to end the year on. I want to give a huge thank you to every single creator who helped me put this project together. I especially want to thank my fellow artists, animators, and sound effect designers. This video wouldn't exist without your talent and support. 2025 was easily one of the most challenging years of my life, but no matter how difficult this year was, and no matter what comes next, I'm incredibly grateful for the amazing audience and community we've built together. This year also marked a huge milestone for Nature's Compendium. For the first time since I started animating, I released more than 4 fully animated long-form videos in a single year, setting a new personal record of 7 total. A massive thank you goes to my Patreon supporters who help make these videos possible. And with several videos already in production, I'm excited to announce 10 new projects coming in 2026. If you'd like to support more animated videos like this, be sure to like and subscribe, and comment #dinosaur below for a chance to win a copy of Prehistoric Kingdom. Now, I want to hear from you. What was your favorite dinosaur discovery of 2025? For me, the recognition of Nanotyrannus as a valid genus takes the cake. You can learn more about this incredible Hell Creek predator in my next video. As always, thank you for watching. And here's to a happy, dinosaur-filled 2026.